धन्यवाद श्री सुकंदर शेखर रॉय।
थैंक यू सर। सर इफ वी लुक एट द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड रीजंस ऑफ दिस कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन अमेंडमेंट बिल एंड ए क्विक विजिट टू द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द पास्ट फोर डिकेड्स कॉन्सर्निंग दिस पर्टिकुलर इशू देन वी विल फाइंड आई वुड लाइक टू से इन ब्रीफ that on 16th May 1974, an agreement between India and Bangladesh was signed inter alia for demarcation of boundaries and for exchange of 162 enclaves, which was a pre-independence legacy. Sir, on 28 November 1974, Bangladesh Parliament ratified the agreement, whereas the successive governments in India failed and neglected to ratify the agreement for long four decades for some inexplicable reasons. However, better late than never. Sir, from 15 July 2011, a head count in enclaves on both sides was conducted and it was found that 37,369 people live in 111 Indian enclaves in Bangladesh and 14,221 live in 57 enclaves of Bangladesh in India. Sir, on 6th of September 2011, a protocol was signed by India and Bangladesh, which has been referred by the Honorable Minister for External Affairs, for exchange of these enclaves and to implement the related matters. Now, sir, when the bill was introduced in 2013, my party, the All India Trinamool Congress, opposed to it. Why? Because the pending social, political and economic issues involved in the matter was neither discussed with the government of West Bengal at the appropriate level, nor the concern expressed by the Honorable Chief Minister of West Bengal, Ms. Mamata Banerjee, who was insisting of this problem for a long time, was not adequately addressed by the government of India. And all these enclaves situated within the district of Kuch Bihar, where the separatist agitation is going on for a long time. I need not go to that extent to explain that thing, but we all are concerned with that. Sir, it is the assessment of the government of West Bengal that all the residents of Bangladeshi enclaves in India would opt to remain in India for two main reasons. They may opt to remain in India for two main reasons. They will not be displaced from their lands and for improvement of their position once the enclaves become parts of India. But the residents of Indian enclaves in Bangladesh might move to India even at the cost of displacement due to better economic opportunities, and which is quite natural and human. Sir, in this backdrop, our Honorable Chief Minister Ms. Mamata Banerjee has urged upon the central government to help the state's intervention, keeping in view maximum displacement, and to extend material help for implementation of a comprehensive rehabilitation program, which must not be a BPL package, but a decent one, a human one, for which the physical and social infrastructure of these enclaves need to be upgraded. Sir, keeping this in mind, the government of West Bengal has urged upon the central government that a sum of ₹3,900 crores be granted, out of which ₹2,234 crores is variable components, and as assured by the Honorable Minister for External Affairs while moving this bill, that the government of India has agreed to sanction the amount as per the requirement. And this is why the West Bengal government has accepted this bill in totality. Sir, once this agreement is implemented, the fate of about 51,000 people will be decided, and long-standing problem between these two countries will be resolved once and for all. Sir, we must not forget that due to partition of the country in 1947, Bengal has sacrificed huge land and natural resources. due to construction of Farakka barrage, when there was a human cry, the West Bengal has shared Ganga water with Bangladesh at the cost of Calcutta port. Now, with this agreement, we are going to exchange the enclaves to have a permanent solution to the long-standing problem. Sir, we have given also blood during the liberation struggle of Bangladesh. Now Mamata Banerjee stands for betterment of the relations between Bangladesh and India to the extent it is desired, subject to the government of India take a stand in help in extending its helping hand to the West Bengal as per the need of the hour and as per the situation demands. Sir, we all of us in Trinamool Congress, we believe that once this agreement is going to be implemented, it would be good for India, it would be good for Bangladesh, it will be good for the people living in the enclaves, and it will also be good for India's relationships with Bangladesh. And we sincerely expect and believe that we have achieved a goal and will further achieve the goal once this agreement is implemented in letter and spirit. I strongly support this bill, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Sri Sundar Sawai.